pro wrestling.
You saw upset victories and smashing action. You saw WWF Vice President Bruce Pritchard attacked by Randy Hales and the Syndicate. You saw new Power Pro Champion Baldo.
Baldo!
Try to ruin the career of Rick Morton. You saw Brandon Baxter challenge Randy Hales and a partner of his choice, and Brandon promises he has made a visit to Bad Street.
Bad Street.
And in the most shocking event of all, you saw Sean Stasiak win the services of Stacey.
Oh, Stacey.
And you saw Baldo.
Baldo!
Cut the hair of Jerry the King long. Today, as always, expect anything on the Power Hour.
Indeed we are. Hello again, everybody. Dave Brown and Corey Macklin here at ringside. We are ready to go with another edition of the Power Hour.
Power Hour is underway. Referee Aubrey Wayne comes to the ring. Here comes the Bulldog. Bulldog Reigns, we're ready for our opening bout today. Got a big 14-man battle royal. That's the main event on the Power Hour.
It promises to be a big day on the Power Hour today. Beginning with this opening match, Bulldog Reigns is going to be going against none other than Brian Christopher.
And here he is!
Tearing up a sign that somebody had.
Yeah, it had Stacy over there. The sign, I think Stacy 469. Instead of 316.
Don't you love me, Dave Brown?
In the ring, we got a match here. No time to talk. Let's get the Power Hour going. Brian Christopher taking time to go around the ring and speak to all the fans.
Yeah, and I'm sure it's not a big welcome from Too Sexy. No. I don't know what's happened to him. His hand has certainly been blown up. Peels off the Too Much jacket. He's one half of the team of Too Much. We'll talk about that a little later on today also.
Yeah.
It's Too Sexy, Brian Christopher, and Bulldog Reigns.
Coming up a little bit later on, we've got this Grudge Challenge match to determine the number one contender for Power Pro Wrestling Champion Baldo. We're going to have Sean Stasiak, Bill Dundee in here. Mick Tierney will be in action.
Uh-huh.
Also, a special word for Bruce Pritchard from the WWF front office. And we may find out who Brandon Baxter's partner is going to be at. You ain't seen nothing yet, which is coming up to New Daisy next Friday night.
Yeah, that's right. Friday night coming up at the New Daisy on Bill. Snap suplex from Too Sexy as he takes the Bulldog down. And hey, we've had great comments today. Great response from everybody that was down at the New Daisy saying, hey, the action is real close. You can see, that's not a bad seat in the house.
No, it's a great venue. The history of Beale Street Historic New Daisy Theater and the history Memphis Wrestling Power Pro, proud to be teamed up with the New Daisy Friday night. That's when we're going to be back down here. 7:30 will be the time. More about it later on. It's called You Ain't Seen Nothing Yet, but that's true.
Too Sexy with a shoulder that knocks the Bulldog down. Millicent, Tennessee, get ready. Power Pro Wrestling coming around Millicent. Right there in Casper Creek, right there at the Recreation Center. Not hard to find if you go past the It's tomorrow night in Millington. I'm going to be out there today, and hopefully we'll see a lot of our old buddies tonight.
Your hometown, right? All right.
Look at that. Nice body slam, and again, Bulldog Reigns body slams him down. Man, he's putting it too sexy. Bulldog with a big right hand. He nails Brian Christopher.
He had the support of the crowd. Wow. Over that top rope he goes.
Finds himself down on the concrete floor, courtesy of the Bulldog. Well, this Bulldog's a big guy, dude.
He is indeed, and Brian Christopher is saying something to the referee. I don't know what. Bulldog over to help him in the ring, but Brian helps him out of the ring instead.
Oh, slams him right into the ring post. Brian ringside, and out on the floor they go. Finally, he rolls Bulldog back in the ring.
Christopher up on the top rope. He springs. That's his Bulldog. The Bulldog in the back of the neck.
Too Sexy Christopher stands up. He's back in this thing now as he slams Bulldog right into that top turnbuckle.
Yeah, he wanted to take control again. He's used to having control in the match, and he didn't. Bulldog Reigns did. Oh, here's Bulldog coming back with a clothesline.
He's got it again, Dave. Look at Bulldog Reigns. He's back on top now. Forearm up to Too Sexy Brian Christopher. A reversal. He whips him into the ropes. Comes back. Bulldog sets him up. DDT takes him down. And Too Sexy Brian Christopher has been in a struggle with Bulldog, boy. This is certainly no walkover for Christopher.
Bulldog did not try to finish him off. I wonder if he should have right there. Now Christopher moves out of the way as Bulldog Reigns springs off the ropes, and Bulldog ends up lying in the middle of the ring.
You know, great point, Dave, that, he probably should have finished him off because he made a huge mistake right there. And Christopher comes off the top. He flies down 2-3 count, and it proved to be a mistake that Bulldog didn't go for the cover earlier in that match.
Yeah, I thought Bulldog might have had a pretty good chance of taking him there, but he made the mistake, and all of a sudden it's Christopher with a hand raised. Bruce Pritchard was here last week. He was attacked by the Syndicate, but Bruce Pritchard has a few words about that situation. Let's hear what Bruce had to say.
First of all, I'd like to thank the folks there in Memphis, Tennessee, for the hospitality that you showed me last week when I was in Tennessee as a guest of Jerry the King Lawler. Second of all, I'd like to apologize to Corey Macklin and Dave Brown for, well, my conduct and getting out from behind the announcer's booth and doing what I did to Randy Hales. And I guess in some ways I might have got what I deserve by being attacked by the Syndicate. But the fact is, Randy Hales, you are nothing but a Vince McMahon wannabe. And your Syndicate, well, it's pretty impressive. And you've got the big Power Pro champion, Big Baldo. Well, Baldo, I told you I made a phone call, and I called some friends at the World Wrestling Federation, and I've got somebody that can handle a big guy like you, and I'd like to bring him on right now. Because he stands 7'7" tall. He weighs 450 pounds, and we call him the Giant Silva, and I guarantee you that the Giant Silva can handle you, Baldo. And then there was this guy, Vic Grimes. He calls himself the original bad guy, Mr. Hardcore, Mr. Extreme. Well, I've got another friend I'd like to introduce you to, and this guy's the original bad guy, the original Mr. Extreme.
Surprise, surprise. Right when you thought it was safe. Right?
Oh, no.
Right, buddy? We're going down to Memphis. Great home. We've been there before. No strangers there.
Oh, no. Hey, Doc, you think you could handle this guy, Vicious Vic Grimes?
Vic Vicious, it don't matter. Come on, Daddy. I'm going to put the chiropractor to light. The Oklahoma Stampede, Daddy.
Oh, I can hardly wait. And you see, there was a third member, the Blue Chipper. Sean Stasiak. Yeah, there were three of them that jumped me. They were real brave. They jumped me from behind. The Blue Chipper. So, Sean, Mr. Paranoid, I want to introduce you to somebody that you might remember. You see, because he taught you everything you know. The only problem is he didn't teach you everything that he knows. My brother, Tom.
You see, Sean, when you were up here in Stanford training, trying to get your feet wet to be a wrestler, I told you you had to go to Memphis, Tennessee, and don't drive anybody nuts. But you want to talk about being paranoid. You drove me nuts up here. You're driving people nuts down there. I'm hearing the stories about you in the locker room. I'm hearing the stories from the people in Memphis. And they're all talking about what a nut, what a paranoid schizo you are, Sean. You need those hair plugs, I think.
Hey, you know, guys, I know that each one of you guys could handle each one of the Syndicate individually. But what if we made it a tag team match? All three of these guys, and then what if it was all four of us? And what if I got in the ring? And I tell you what, I will get in the ring and team with these guys if you, Randy Hales, will get in the ring and team with your Syndicate, and we'll just make it an eight-man tag down there on Beale Street at the New Daisy Theater next Friday night.
What, you mean so if Randy Hales gets in the tag match, any one of us could get a hold of him too?
Oh, yeah. That means maybe all of us can get a hold of Randy Hales in an eight-man tag match. So, Randy, if you've got the guts, come on down to the New Daisy next Friday night right there on Beale Street, and the four of us will face the four of you if you've got the guts.
Well, we'll find out, I guess, huh? Man, that could be something else, let me tell you.
I mean,
coming up here, we're going to have more on that situation with Stasiak and Stacy and the King, yeah. Jerry Lawler, the haircutting and all of that when we come back. Right now, let's take a look at the action coming up on tour. Millington, Tennessee, tomorrow night at Casper Creek Recreation Center, Lula, Mississippi, at the Lady Luck Casino on Thursday, Friday at the New Daisy, you ain't seen nothing yet, Saturday the 13th, Jonesboro, Arkansas, at Earl Bell Community Center, Sunday the 14th, the Pyramid, the WWF will be here, Saturday, February 20th, at Mount Pleasant, Mississippi, and in South Haven at the high school. That one is coming up on Saturday, February 27th. Big action coming up at New Daisy Theater. Coming up on Friday night. Right now, Sean Stasiak. Hey, Stasiak, before you go to the ring, come on over here. Stasiak's got a match coming up. Last week, of course, we saw what happened with that situation with you and Stacy.
Well, as you know, I won Stacy last week, and I'll tell you something.
Yeah, sort of.
Just listen to what I got to say, all right? I won her fair and square, and she's let me down. I'm very disappointed in her as a valet, you know. She doesn't do what I tell her to do. She doesn't wear what I tell her to wear. I mean, just last Thursday at the Lady Luck Casino, I had picked out a beautiful piece of lingerie. What does she do? She comes out in normal street clothes.
Well, of course.
So, because she is now not here, as you can see, I want to show all these people what I had to say to her at the Lady Luck Casino. And let's go ahead and roll that film right now.
Get in here right now. Shut your mouth. Get in here. We're
going to
talk.
Sean, this is the bathroom.
Just get in here. We're going to get something straight right now. You're my valet. You understand that? You do what I say when I say to do it. You wear what I tell you to wear. You don't ever come out and wear something that I don't approve of. You understand me?
Yes.
You do what I tell you to do. You keep your mouth shut. And another thing, if you ever, ever open your mouth and tell the referee what I'm doing, it'll be the last thing you've ever said. You got it?
Yeah.
Yes, what?
Yes, sir.
Well, that whole thing is ridiculous, I want to tell you. And I want to point out, too, that Stacy agreed to the stipulation on that match. We were all against it.
Well, another thing that she does is she opens her big mouth to the referee about my business. So for punishment, you're wondering where she is. Stacy, you're not a very good valet around the ring. Let's see if you're a good valet around the house. I know you're watching right now. That house better be spotless, and when I come home, you better have a meal on the table ready for the blue chipper.
Servant, huh? Well, Mr. Stasiak, I got a feel there's going to be some payback coming for all of that from none other than the King, Jerry Lawler himself. Well, Randy Hales and Bruno Lauer and Baldo and
yeah, and Brian Christopher, get Sean Stasiak's opponent out here right now because I have a few short things to say. First of all,
hope they're short.
Richard runs his mouth. He runs his mouth. Look, he's telling me to 8-man tag team match.
Did you see those guys? Yeah, Giant Silver for one. He's what, 9 feet tall?
Did you hear that?
I heard him.
Giant Silver gets there. You gonna be around?
Oh, I can't wait to see that. Friday night, right, Randy?
How about the match I got you scheduled in the Joe? Are y'all gonna kill him? I haven't even told him the deal. Let me tell you who you're wrestling. You and Scott Taylor, 2 months. Against Dundee and Derry King. Isn't that good?
Look at Dundee. Look how old and decrepit.
You guys just celebrate. Just have fun. Just have fun.
Yeah, they're sitting here talking and laughing right now.
Yeah.
Bruce Pritchard and his guys, they're serious about Friday night.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
That's right.
Hey, yeah. You know who's serious is Sean Stasiak. You know what I heard? I heard he's got Stacy scrubbing the toilet with her own toothbrush.
Oh, my God. He'll make a man. Well, I'm not even going to ask you that question.
You're about to make me mad already, let me tell you. That whole deal, I don't like that at all.
Well, can we talk about something else? This ain't seen nothing yet.
Or maybe it was
me.
It was you. Yeah, it was a good name. All right.
Believe me, you ain't seen nothing till you see Too Sexy and Too Hot in the same ring together. And if you show up at the New Daisy, that's what you're going to see, the greatest team in the world.
Pay-per-view?
Oh, yeah, we'll be there. We're going to be in the pyramid, too.
That's a little...
No way.
Don't forget action coming up in Millington tomorrow night, 7 o'clock.
Yeah, big night.
I'll be there, too.
Well, let me tell you guys this. Bruce Pritchard is bringing in Dr. Death. Dr. Death.
How are you interrupting Corey?
He don't want to talk about it. Well, I tell you,
Disqualification.
No reason for this stuff.
Christopher talking about how old and decrepit Dundee is, and then jumps in there and interferes with the match. Stasiak, obviously. Here comes Waller. Look out.
The king, he's got Stasiak. Oh, he had him, and Stasiak took off. Oh, Lawler's right behind him, though. He's right with John Stasiak. They go out the door.
We got cameras headed that way. What as Stasiak locked himself in the office there, looks like?
I don't know whose office is he in over there, Dave.
Hey.
Lawler's got something. He's shoving the referee. He wants Sean Stasiak.
Lawler is looking for him.
Here he comes.
He's coming this way, so Randy's on his way out of here. I don't see Lawler coming this way. I don't know where he went, but I tell you what, the syndicate got real nervous all of a sudden.
Yeah, Randy says, here he comes. He takes off. Boy, he took out of here like a kite.
Well, he's after Stasiak, and I hope he finds it.
Yeah.
All right, let's take a look at the action coming up. Actually, ain't seen nothing yet, which is going to be Friday night at the New Daisy Theater. Superstars will be there from Power Pro Wrestling and from the WWF. Bulldog Reigns will be going against Mick Tierney. Kid Wicked against Lance Jade in opening matches.
Then you got teacher versus student. Dr. Tom Pritchard takes on the blue chipper, Sean Stasiak, all coming up this Friday night at New Daisy.
A ladder match. These things are dangerous.
Oh,
Aaron O'Grady will be going against Vicious Vic Grimes. These guys, quite a history in the last few weeks.
Big grudge here when Venom tangles with Streak Friday night down at the New Daisy.
Yeah, Venom calls Streak a semifinal match last time at the New Daisy.
Yeah.
Power Pro heavyweight title match. It's going to be Baldo going against the WWF Strong.
Oh, that'll be a dandy. And then a challenge tag match. Randy Hales teams up with his longtime buddy Jimmy Cornette, James E. Cornette, down at the New Daisy Friday night. They're going to take on the team of Brandon Baxter and a mystery partner.
Yeah, that Cornette announcement made earlier in the week. We'll hear more from him later. First round match, Power Pro Tag Tournament, which is going to be ongoing. Bill Dundee and Derek King will be going against Too Much. That's Brian Christopher and Scott Taylor.
Then, Dave, it's when two worlds collide. This bout is non-sanctioned. Anything goes. Eight-man tag. It's Power Pro Wrestling, PPW, versus the World Wrestling Federation.
Oh, that would should be something else. Eight-man match, and look out, all the folks there. Make your plans to be there. It's at the New Daisy Theater. It's going to be Friday night. There's no increase in price, even though we got WWF talent coming there.
Ain't seen nothing yet.
Ain't
until
seen
Friday night.
Yet. Ain't seen nothing yet here. We got more of the Power Hour coming up.
The storytellers. Celebrate Black history with HBO. Experience the courage, the hope, the triumphs, and more.
From the King, Jerry Lawler, if we can find him, want to get some word from the King. I know he's looking for Sean Stasiak. He was hot on his trail earlier. And, here he is. Here is the King. A tough road to hoe the last few weeks. Baldo coming out with scissors and cutting the hair of the King and all this stuff. And it's just been, it's been tough the last few weeks, King.
Yeah, you know what? If you don't mind, if you could back that camera up just a little bit, because I'm going to do a little shouting here.
Jerry!
I'm going to talk right now to Sean Stasiak. But first of all, Baldo, I want you to know that you and I got a little date somewhere down the line, but right now I'm going to put your big butt right on the back burner because I got more important business to take care of and Sean Stasiak. Now, Stasiak, you know it's going to be you and I. We're gonna get together over in Millington Sunday night. But I'll tell you what, why do we have to wait till Millington? You come out here and shoot your mouth off. Woo! You go in the ring with Bill Dundee, and when the King shows up, you take a powder. Well, why don't you come back out here right now, and let's show everybody just exactly how tough you are. Unlock that little door.
There he is, King. There he is. Yeah, he's got some work.
What?
We don't have to wait till Sunday, Millington. Let's do it right now. I'm not hard to find.
That's what you just
Neither is Stacy. She's at my apartment right now cooking my meals. What do you think of that?
I'll show you exactly what I think.
Uh-oh. Well, Jerry knows exactly where he is. He's headed that way, Dave. Lawler's going up. Stasiak takes off. Up the staircase they go. That's back in the storage area here at the
back,
television.
Back up in the storage wall.
Lawler after him.
Come on.
Hey, I mentioned that Lawler's had a tough few weeks. The last few weeks, and he's trying to throw Stasiak off the top of those stairs up there.
Bruno Lauer and Aubrey Wayne, there's some of the officials.
Lawler's hot. You can't blame him, though.
No, I'm with him. I would be angry, too. I'm glad Jerry is angry because some of the stuff that Stasiak has said and done is inexcusable.
It's ridiculous. Totally ridiculous. That's Mr. Coffee, Buddy Wayne.
But what they're trying to do right now is to keep Jerry from throwing him off that top of that loft, I think. Which, that's a good thing. They want to keep him from doing that, that's for sure. But Jerry, understandably, and also upset, although at Baldo, see the back of his head there, how the gouges. Baldo and Stasiak teaming up with him last week.
I'm not going out of any building. Get out of here, Stasiak! Come on, you're out of control. We can't have that around here. You know that.
What did they say? They tell him to leave the building?
Who's that?
He's headed back in the studio. No, he's not headed in the studio.
They said they're barring him from the...
He's out of control.
They said Lawler's out of control. They're barring him from the building.
Well, he's out of control with good reason.
Well, you can't blame him, yeah.
They're escorting him to the door. And once that door locks, he's out of there. He's pleading his case. Is it going to do any good?
No.
Well,
yeah,
there's security.
They're closing the door. Lawler is out of the building. He has been escorted out.
Well, I tell you, Dave, I just don't know if I agree with that.
I don't know
either.
They
pull all of that stuff on Jerry, and there's only so much anybody can take.
That's very true. Let's take us a break, regroup. We'll be back in just a moment.
Take a break. I want to remind you about Power 4 on tour. Millington, Tennessee tomorrow night, 7:30 bell time. Casper Creek Recreation Center. Lula, Mississippi at the Lady Luck coming up Thursday night. You ain't seen nothing yet until Friday night at the New Daisy. Earl Bell for Jonesboro coming up next Saturday. The Pyramid, February 14th with the World Wrestling Federation. Mount Pleasant, Mississippi coming up. And South Haven at the South Haven High School. That's Power 4 on tour. Okay, still to come today on the Power Hour, we've got the big 14-man battle royal that's going to determine the number one contender for a shot at the Power Pro heavyweight title. That's coming up right now. I want to talk to the Irish Assassin, Mick Tierney. Let me tell you, certainly not a pleasure at all when you're around this guy. Just stay loose.
How you doing this evening?
All right, thank you.
You know, they got me booked here tonight with Derek King. Now, this lad must be suffering from amnesia because he's already forgotten about the last time we met when I beat the living gobshite out of him. Now, he's 5'2", 115 pounds. He can't have more than an ounce of muscle on his entire body.
More than 115.
I don't think so, lad. Now, he's done his training playing Nintendo. Oh. I did my training on the back streets of Belfast.
USA!
Now, this is no game. This is reality, and he's about to learn how painful reality really is.
Well, let me tell you, this guy is tough, but he can certainly back up everything he says. Mick Tierney, I don't like the way he does it, Dave, but he can't do it.
No, he is tough, though. He's the master of the submission hole, too.
Here comes Mr. Personalities, Derek King, and Derek has Mick Tierney. Here's the superstar.
Well done, D. Yeah.
Bill.
Hey, Mick, Turney.
Hey,
oh,
Turney.
You're big and bad, all right. Hey, didn't you have to start somewhere? Didn't you have to learn? Well, listen, I made a whole career of fighting big monsters like you, and I'm going to give this guy a few tips. We may not be able to whoop you, but you're going to know you've been in a fight. You're Irish.
Well, let me tell you one thing. If Derek King wants to learn from anybody, the superstar certainly can show him a few things.
He's a man to learn from. He's given away size so many times when he stepped into the ring, just about every time. But he's put together a great one-loss record and a very long, storied career. Superstar Bill Dundee with Derek King under his wing here today.
Yeah, Derek's under his wing, and Derek is a young man that has certainly shown us a lot of great moves in the ring. He's done had a lot of good bouts in here for the Young Guns title, all of that sort of thing. But when you look across the way and see Mick Tierney, I mean, he's got to scare you. Tierney out talking, saying, "Oh, he only weighs 115 pounds,
right,
and all this stuff." Oh, he runs in, and look at this. Derek rolls him up. 1, 2. Thought we had an upset.
Man, what an upset that would be.
I thought he had it. He rolled him up. Duke down, and Dundee's telling him, "Hey, get in and just watch this big guy."
Dundee coaching from the sidelines and doing a good job of it. Let me tell you, he had a couple of words for Derek right there as Derek now climbs back in the ring.
Derek rolled him up, and I'm sure it was a shocker for Tierney to find his shoulders down on the mat. 4-2 count there, fast from Derek King. Whips him in. Derek runs across the way. Here comes Tierney. Oh, Dundee. Dundee does the old, I guess the old red light, green light.
Yeah.
He pulls his hand up. Now Tierney, he stopped him with a right hand and missed the personality. What a super kick, and it doesn't stagger this big guy.
He got him off his feet. He can't get the shoulders down, though. And now Tierney comes back with that big forearm.
One of those submission holds.
Yep. Only way you can beat Tierney is use speed and agility. If you stop and let Tierney get you in one place, he's going to have you beat.
He's going to get you every time because this guy, he moves slow and around the ring, but very, very effective. He's got Derek in another submission hold. He's hanging on that bottom rope.
Dundee had his hands on the rope there. Tierney broke it, and now Dundee's got a word or two for Derek. Now, Derek's got to be thinking, do I really want to get back in there against this big guy? And what Dundee has to do is convince him he can still win. You can still beat him, Derek. Head back in there.
That's the thing about the old teacher-student thing. Bill Dundee, the teacher, Derek King, the student, and he's standing in against the big Irish assassin, Mick Tierney. Looking forward, Dave, to this 14-man battle royal right here today on the Power Hour. It's our television main event today. Big forearm flying in the air goes Derek King. He whips Tierney into the ropes, trying to hit Dawson, big guy. It's not going to work. Submission hold. He's got Derek's shoulders down even, but he gives it up. He's out. And Tierney won't let go.
Yeah.
See, that's the kind of stuff that makes you frustrated.
Oh, look out. Dundee has his own equalizer there. He takes a chair into the ring.
I bet you that.
He helps Derek King roll out of the ring. That's a good move, too. Don't go back after Tierney. Get out of the ring and come back another day in another match. Tierney is going to get the victory here. He's got it by submission over Derek King. Derek, really, though, gave him a go with the help of superstar Bill Dundee. Mick Tierney knows he has been in a match. Let's take a look at some of the action coming up on tour. The Power Pro Wrestling on tour beginning in Millington. Tomorrow night, Casper Creek Recreation Center. The King will be there.
No doubt about it. It's 7:30 bell time. Correct you there. 7:30 bell time tomorrow night right there in Millington.
Tell them how to get there. You're familiar with the area.
Hey, Edmund Orgel Park. If you go to Edmund Orgel Golf Course, you've gone too far. Everybody in Millington knows pretty much what Casper Creek is. But the Recreation Center, you just go off, you turn off Navy Road onto Bethel, make a left turn on Bethel, go down Bethel there. It's about a mile. You turn right right there, and Casper Creek Recreation Center is sitting right there. We're going to be out there at 7:30 bell time tomorrow night in Millington, Tennessee, 7:30 bell time. Too Sexy's going to be there. Going to be a big night tomorrow night.
And then coming up in Jonesboro, Arkansas, it's going to be next Saturday night, the biggest card ever. K-Fine is going to be involved in this one. This means war, it's called. WWF stars will be there. Look at all the names, all in Jonesboro. No price increase. Next week, pick up your tickets in advance.
Hey, there's been a lot of great wrestling action over in Jonesboro, but Dave, this has got to be one of the biggest cards ever in Jonesboro. Front Page Cafe, advance tickets there. Bill's Superfood, you can pick them up there. Oh, also Bilo has advance tickets as well. And United Pawnbrokers. They also coming up in Jonesboro, while we're on Jonesboro, Arkansas Sports Show is at the Convocation Center. It's on campus of ASU right there in Jonesboro, 4 p.m. to 9 p.m. And K-Fine has
that's
a booth.
Today, right?
That's today, 4 o'clock until 9, all over the campus of ASU. Brandon Baxter is going to be out there in the K-Fine booth coming up
very
today.
Very good. And next Saturday?
Yeah, next Saturday, got a deal coming up 1 o'clock until 4 o'clock over at Excite. Over on American Way.
I'm very that good. Time. That's action coming up at Power Pro Wrestlers. Uh-huh. Will be there.
Make
your plans to attend. Right here.
Yep.
Don't go away. We're not done yet.
Wrestling with all my bills.
Wrestle? Did I hear somebody say wrestle?
King.
Listen, you don't have to wrestle with bills or any money problems. Just call my friends at Golden Title Loans, 745 Cash, and get a loan on your title or check advance.
Really, King?
Sure, and there's absolutely no hassle. No credit check. Just call 745-CASH.
Everyone.
Well, the founder, the owner, and the president of Power Pro Wrestling has joined us once again.
Month after month after month, Brandon Baxter. Last week, you issued a challenge. Well, one of my closest friends in the world, I'm bringing in to You Ain't Seen Nothing Yet as a tag team partner, one of the biggest stars, one of the greatest wrestling managers in the history of the world. Let's take a look at my tag team partner, the world famous James E. Cornette.
Well, you know, everybody's asking the question, Jim Cornette, why are you siding with Randy Hales when all the rest of your WWF superstars are taken up for their beloved executive vice president, Bruce Pritchard? Well, the answer is real simple, just like most of you people. It's because I don't like Bruce Pritchard. Love his brother Tom to death, but I don't like Bruce. Because he's like all those other executives, sits around his big spacious office all day, talking on the phone, 1-900-DATE-ME, telling people where to go and what to do, sitting there wearing his empty suit. Well, Randy Hale's going to fix Bruce Pritchard up real good. But Randy told me there's another guy that's been a pain in his neck, another guy that's been a thorn in his side, some little wet-behind-the-ears punk named Brandon Baxter running around down there, getting in Randy Hales' way. And Randy called me and he said, Jim, I need a partner. I need somebody I can count on. Well, I've been Randy Hales' friend for 20 years, and I told him I'd be there February the 12th in Memphis. Now, Brandon Baxter, you go out and you get you a mystery partner. Who's it going to be, punk? Your mother? Can't be your father. He died 20 years ago. You don't have any friends, so you're going to get some guy from the Fallen Crawl Tavern or some guy with grease under his fingernails from the Jiffy Lube. You bring him on down there to that Daisy Theater on February the 12th, because when Jim Cornette and Randy Hales get in the ring together, oh, Lord, people of Memphis, Brandon Baxter, you little pencil-neck jerk, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Friday night, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Hey,
as old JC said, man, it's going to be a great night, and Baxter don't have no partner.
You ain't seen nothing yet. Brandon, what's going on?
You know, I guess I'm standing back here with egg on my face, Randy. I didn't think you'd be able to go out and get a partner. James, let's maybe play the WWF promo for that pay-per-view.
Hi, everybody. Handsome Doc Hendricks of the WWF here to talk about the big weekend in Memphis. Of course, St. Valentine's Day Massacre at the Pyramid, Sunday, February 14th.
Did you hear that? Did you hear what I just heard? I think I heard someone breathe a sigh of relief. And could that someone be Randy Hales?
Randy, got bad news for you. Handsome Doc Hendricks ain't coming to Memphis. You want to know why? Because coming back after a long, long time is none other than Michael P.S. Hayes, born on Bad Street, USA. And the reason they called it Bad Street was the further you went down the block, the better it got. And we lived in the last house on the right. See, back in 1994, I met this up-and-coming young prospect, and I really took a shine to him. I liked him. I took him under my wing. Like a little brother to me. And I told him, I said, Brandon, oh yeah, I am talking about Brandon Baxter. Brandon, anytime you think that you need some help, don't you hesitate to pick up the phone, because you are not alone, and call OPS. Well, you'll never guess what happened last week. Phone rang. and it was Brandon Baxter, and he wants help. Friday night, February 12th, me and Brandon taking on you and James E. Cornette. Have you forgotten that the Fabulous Freebirds were born right there in Memphis, Tennessee, 20 years ago in 1979? If you need some references, go ask Jerry Lawler, because I done kicked it enough times. See, what you don't know is I am old school with a new twist. I've been all that, and trust me, I am still all this. I am exceptional with no exceptions, and I'm proud to be known as the king of deception. Been known to hitch a ride with a trucker, and everyone in Memphis knows Michael is one bad mother. Gotcha. I gotcha, didn't I? See, I still love to rock, and I still love to roll. And trust me, on February 12th, I'll make you lose your self-control. You will feel so much anticipation. And you know what? I have never cared about my bad reputation, because I don't need 69 to have my fun. We'll do 68, and I'll just owe you one. The bottom line is this. I'm coming to Memphis, and ain't nobody going to stop me. It's been 4 years in the making. And if you ask anybody in the dressing room, they'll remind you, I'm stiff. I'm real stiff. So Friday night, February 12th, Brandon, the Bad Street Boogie's coming to town. And guess what, Randy Hales? You and Jim Cornette?
Ain't got a prayer. You made a call, and Brandon made a call. Yeah. Michael P.S. Hayes coming Friday night.
That's Baxter's people. That is not right.
He's coming. And it's you and Cornette. And Cornette doesn't know anything about it. Hey, Brandon, did you have something else to say?
In closing, Randy Hales, Friday night, Beale Street becomes Bad Street.
Bad Street, USA.
Of extraordinary change in social power.
Well, Power Pro Wrestling has a new champion after last week, as you probably know. Baldo won the championship in a rugged evening at the New Basin Theater. He now needs an opponent or two. And this match right here is a 14-man tournament to determine the number one contender for Baldo's Power Pro Championship.
Here come all of the contenders. Downtown Bruno, leading boy Tony in. Got the blue chipper Sean Stasiak, Mick Tierney, Vicious Big Grimes, Too Sexy Brian Christopher, the Birdman, Coco Beware, all involved.
Here comes Baldo himself with all the gold. He has the Young Guns trophy, which he won a few weeks ago, and he has the Power Pro Heavyweight Championship belt slung over his shoulder.
Kid Wicked struck out.
Vic Grimes and Baldo with a few words there. If it comes to you against me, Vic Grimes says it's going to be me. Yeah.
Power's here.
Well, the power is here. Look here at this ring side. Full here.
Yeah, Bulldog Reigns, Aaron O'Grady, Superstar Bill Dundee, Lance Jay, Derek King, a bunch of them hit the ring.
These people in the tournament, from Kid Wicked to Jerry the King Lawler.
Well, you didn't beat them all, but you did win the tournament. There's no doubt about it. Baldo, a legitimate Power Pro Wrestling champion, the first ever in what many folks consider to be
champion, as well as the Young Guns. which I'm not too proud to say is mine.
That's very
this
true.
Belt right here means everything. If anyone trying to take it, remember one thing. I'm not responsible for what happens to you.
Well, a lot of folks surprised that Baldo came out as the champion, but he did it in the tournament, and he is now the holder of that belt.
Sure is. Battle Royal underway. Let me tell you this, Baldo. You're definitely going to have a number one contender, and we're going to determine who the number one contender will be at a conclusion of this Battle Royal right here today. It's our main event. Been talking about it, been looking forward to it all day on the Power Hour.
Brian Christopher would like to win the tournament. He thinks it's his time in the world.
And, double headbutt from Christopher there on Derek King and Kid Wicked. Big Grimes over in the corner against O'Grady. There goes Lance Shade over the top rope. He's out.
He's a lucky man. Lance Shade is a lucky man.
Lance Shade is out. Mick Tierney and Derek King both out.
There goes Mick Tierney. Baldo telling Tierney, hey, you're lucky that you don't win this thing and
Derek
able to fight again.
Derek and Tierney kind of continuing their earlier match. They were tied up over on the rope, flipped over the rope, so both of them are eliminated.
Yeah, they're both out of there. Christopher's got Kid Wicked right here on the side. Trying to dump Kid up. There goes Boy Tony.
Bill Dundee eliminates him.
And he throws Boy Tony right over the top.
Tony, that's the man I thought was going to be the number one contender. Or at least I hope.
I bet you did hope, but not to be. Who we got left here? Kid Wicked, Brian Christopher, Coco Beware, Sean Stasiak, Aaron O'Grady, Vic Grimes, Bulldog Reigns, all still in contention. You notice Jerry Lawler is not in contention to be a number one contender. He was escorted out of the building earlier by Power Pro officials and has not been allowed back in.
Aaron O'Grady with the boot. Yeah, that's Kid Wicked going. I thought O'Grady was going to get a piece of Stasiak and possibly get him out, but it didn't work. Coco Ware has been eliminated also. I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take a break. We'll keep the tapes rolling in this Battle Royal for the number one contender for the Power Pro Heavyweight title. We'll be back with more.
Will you have to lose your job?
You thought you'd seen it all. You ain't seen nothing yet.
This Friday night, it's Power Pro Wrestling at the New Daisy on Field. It's non-sanctioned where the WWF superstars face the Power Pro Syndicate in an eight-man tag war. See 7-foot-plus giant Silva, Dr. Death Steve Williams, Draws, Brandon Baxter, Freebird Michael Hayes, Randy Hales, James E. Cornette, Bill Dundee, Brian Christopher, Sean Stasiak, Baldo, and much more.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
Friday night, 8 p.m., the New Daisy Theater on Field.
While we were away, Bulldog Reigns was eliminated by Brian Christopher. We got Christopher, Dundee, Aaron O'Grady, Vicious Vic Grimes, Sean Stasiak, still alive in this tournament. 14-man Power Pro Contender Battle Royal underway here. The winner is the number one contender to go against Baldo.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Look at Vicious Vic Grimes. Oh. He just tosses O'Grady over the top.
O'Grady holding on.
He didn't hit the floor. There goes Grimes.
He didn't hit the floor, but now Grimes pulls him out of there. Both of them out. Superstar Bill Dundee, Brian Christopher, Sean Stasiak. Uh-oh, this is not good. I just realized what you got here. We got a two against one with Stasiak and Brian Christopher.
Down to these three finalists. Superstar Bill Dundee. Looks like it's going to be two against one here today. Stasiak and Christopher. And after all,
Baldo, the champion, has been out here with a comment every now and then. We found that Baldo is not a very popular champion from the reaction of the crowd, too. He'll be in action 8 o'clock at the New Daisy Theater on Friday night.
8 o'clock, bell time.
8 o'clock.
Stasiak. that. Over in the corner, Dundee after him. Oh, Christopher's getting Bill.
Could be a problem here.
They're double teaming Dundee, but the problem here, Dave, is that if they double team Bill, get him out, then it's Stasiak against Christopher.
Well, Sean better watch himself because Christopher will turn on him in a second. And I got a feeling that the reverse is also true.
Yeah. Baldo, the Power Pro champion at ringside, looks on for the number one contender who's going to get a shot at this Power Pro heavyweight title.
Number one unlucky contender. Because there's no winning when you're getting there trying to take this belt. Like I said last week, you have a better chance beating a grizzly.
Dundee's in trouble. It's beginning to look like he will not have the chance to go against Baldo.
Christopher sets him up. Christopher runs in a clothesline.
Time is winding down. We've got about a minute left.
Time is winding down in this one for the battle royal, yeah. Here today on the Power Hour, Stasiak runs over.
Christopher down. Eliminated by Stasiak.
Dundee
doesn't remember it, Dundee. Dundee looked like he was out of it, but he wins it.
We pretty much counted him out of it, Dave.
Yeah.
And a superstar, Bill Dundee, the number one contender for the championship. Look out, Bill.
And now Brian Christopher and Sean Stasiak go after Dundee as Baldo is in there. But Dundee, the number one contender. Don't forget, 8 o'clock Friday night at the New Daisy Theater. Next week, we'll see you live right here on the Power Hour. Till then, for Corey Macklin, I'm Dave Brown. So long, everybody.
Hello, Lisa. I heard about your new...